filming another Will I Buy It video. Now these videos have gotten so popular on YouTube. I've seen a lot of the bigger YouTube gurus hop on the train. Originally started by Kimberly Clark, she does the What I'm Not Gonna Buy, which I think is super genius. And then I saw Samantha March here on YouTube. She does a Will I Buy It Wednesdays, and she just talks about new product launches and things that are coming out, and she talks about whether she's gonna buy them or not. And so I really like that because there is a lot of makeup coming out constantly, and I'm always like, am I gonna get it? Am I not gonna get it? So it's always fun to make these videos and share ideas with other YouTubers. So let me know if you're planning on buying some of this stuff, and I'll let you know if I am or if I'm not. So the first thing I wanted to talk about is the Lorac Pirates of the Caribbean palette, eyeshadow palette, lipsticks. They did blush palette and all that stuff, and honestly I did pick up the Pirates of the Caribbean eyeshadow palette, but it was really for review purposes. I'm not into cool tone eyeshadow palettes, so personally I would have never bought that other than for a review. And I'm kind of getting away from the Lorac eyeshadows. I've said that multiple times in my videos, so I'm gonna put that to the test and I'm gonna share my thoughts with you guys pretty soon here. Next are the ColourPop Blotted Lips. I'm sure you guys have seen those all over the internet as well. Super into those. I had two shades from the Alexis Ren collection, so I did pick up some of the Ultra Blotted Lips. Those were out of stock, but then they did restock last Friday and ColourPop was doing a sale, so I snagged a few of those, so reviews on those will be up soon. And then the Urban Decay Jean Michel Basquiat collection. You guys have probably already seen my review on that. I definitely was all about that life. I thought those palettes were really, really amazing, so I'll go ahead and throw up my review in the cards as well as link it down below if you're interested. Another collection that's already out is a collab by Kim Kardashian West and Kylie Cosmetics. I did post on my Instagram that I was passing on that collection. I thought it was super beautiful, but I'm really not into pinky nudes. I'm more into like the sienna shades, like the darker brown shades, because I just feel like that complements my skin a lot better because I have a warm tone like complexion, and pinky nudes, I just think they look so awkward on my lips. So definitely passing on that, even though the packaging was super cute and I was so tempted to get some of that. I'm also going to be passing on the Marc Jacobs coconut collection. They had a coconut bronzer, highlight, a brush, a bunch of stuff, really expensive. I would have maybe thought about the bronzer, but I just think it's a little too light for my skin tone, so I'm definitely passing on that. Also going to be passing on Huda highlighters. I honestly am never gonna buy anything from Huda Beauty ever again. I just think it's overpriced and her packaging is crap, and yeah, I just feel like there's better stuff out there, so I'm not gonna buy it. Natasha Denona has been coming out with a bunch of stuff as well. She came out with a sculpt and highlighting palette, and she's got like new foundations launching, and now she's on sale at Sephora, so I've seen a lot of beauty gurus talk about her. Here's the thing though, right? Because there's all that like Natasha Denona controversy, and I've been doing some research on that. If you guys watched the Fancy Face, because she did like a full-blown review, and then she also talked about like how Natasha Denona had like started some drama with her on Instagram, and I just decided to do my own digging, because really, who is Natasha Denona? Like, she's supposed to be like the celebrity makeup artist from like Israel or somewhere. She's like overseas, but I can't find more than like one picture of her on Google. Like, if you just go to Google and type Natasha Denona, you're not gonna find any pictures of her or any of her work really. It's all like other people's makeup looks that come up. Whereas like, for example, Makeup My Mario, you can find his stuff. You know who he is. He has a face. And Charlotte Tilbury too. She's like very famous British makeup artist. So I'm just like really sketched out by the whole Natasha Denona thing, because she really is one of the more expensive brands. She has like a $250 eyeshadow palette, and I know a lot of people have purchased those eyeshadow palettes. It's just that, I mean, who is she? Like, I feel like she's scamming everyone. And I have one of her eyeshadow palettes, and it could be that I just got a really bad eyeshadow palette, but I think it's just a hot glittery mess. Like, there's better matte shades, there's better glitter shades out there for way less money. So I just feel like Natasha Denona is like scamming all of us, and we just don't know yet. Next collection I'm gonna hard pass on is the new NARS Charlotte Gainsborough collection. I'm not gonna lie, I have no idea who that is. I thought it was an interesting collection, but none of it really screams out to me, so hard pass on that. I'm also thinking of passing on the Becca Christie Teigen palette the more I think about it, because I really haven't made any dents in the Jaclyn Hill palette. And I recently did a blush collection video, and you guys know I am not in the market for any blush right now, so I think I'm actually gonna pass on that palette. But if you guys are planning on getting it, definitely let me know down below. Next thing I'm passing on, and it makes me really sad, is the Kathleen Lights Kale Polish Spring Collection. I have a few of her first line from the fall, and they're so nice, but I've recently been getting my nails done, and so I'm like, I don't need to get my nails done and buy nail polish. It's like one or the other, so I'm gonna go ahead and continue to get gel nails, so I'm gonna pass on those, even though the shades are so cute, and I just wanna buy the bundle because I love all the colors she came out with. So if you're really into spring shades, definitely check out the Kale Polish line, because she did an amazing job with her spring line. I'm gonna pass on the new Hourglass blushes and bronzers. I, again, in my blush video, talk about how I rarely ever use my Ambient Edit palette that I got a couple of years ago. Passing on the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Vault, that huge lipstick collection they just launched that's available for like $100 and something. And I just saw Trend Mood posted that they also came up with a vault for the Make Believe in Yourself collection. I reviewed that on my channel here, and I didn't like the eyeshadow palette. I do have the brushes up there. Those are really cute, but you definitely don't need the vault. Not gonna be getting the Kat Von D Everlasting Lip Liners. I just don't feel like you should pay the same amount of money for lip liners as you would a liquid lipstick. I just don't really need them. And I wear a lot of liquid lipsticks, so I just don't see the point. I'm gonna be passing on the Zoeva collection. I'm still pending review on the Zoeva palettes. I got three of them almost a month ago. I just haven't dug into them yet. So far, I'm not like super impressed. I feel like it's a little bit overhyped, but I did see Trend Mood just posted that Sephora is gonna start selling Zoeva sometime this summer. So that'll be interesting. I'm gonna try and get those reviews up before Zoeva launches in America. And then I'm gonna be passing on the new summer shades of the Beauty Blender. I have found so many new drugstore dupes for Beauty Blenders that I won't be ever buying any more Beauty Blenders. I just feel like it is a great sponge, but like the L'Oreal, you know, foundation sponge is just as good, and it's like $7. So I will not be buying any more Beauty Blenders. I'm gonna be passing on the Violet Voss Rose Gold Highlighting Palette. I just don't need any more highlighters. I think it's beautiful, but girl, nobody needs like that many shades of rose highlighters, you know? I can justify like the Anastasia ones because I feel like there's enough shade variation, but this palette is just all rose gold themed, and it's just, it's not worth it for me. I'm gonna be passing on the Milk Cosmetics highlighters. Again, I have one of the Milk eyeshadow stacks, and I just don't think their products are worth the hype, so I will be passing on that as well. And then I don't know if you guys saw the new Naked like contour palettes that are coming out. Definitely gonna be passing on those as well. I just don't use contouring products, and especially not cream. I think contour is just kind of like a dying trend, really. It's not something you really need. A lot of people just, you know, tack on to trends really hard, but I haven't contoured in forever, and honestly, in the summertime, you don't really need it, and you should just be buying like a fun bronzer to just, you know, warm up your cheeks. I'm also passing on the Lancôme Matte Juicy Shakers. They came out with a line last year of those like little shaky things, and now they have a matte line. I just feel like those things are so gimmicky. They're $22, and I can go ahead and show you guys my review of the ones that came out last time, but I am just not getting any more of those. The next thing is something I am gonna buy. If you guys saw, Juvia's Place is coming out with a new eyeshadow palette, and I can't wait to get my grubby little hands on those. They have it's called the Magic palette. Looks gorgeous, and they're also coming out with some eyeshadow palettes, and they're also coming out with some blush palettes that I'm super super excited for, so I will definitely be picking those up. I'm gonna hard pass on the Too Faced Candy Johnson collab. I just don't have any more time for Too Faced. You know, it has to be something really exciting, and I'm just not going to be getting any more of that stuff. I really wanted to try these Pure Royalty collection. I really wanted to try Mac Daddy's these like polish eye like shadow thingies that he came out with them, but I just feel like it's something that I'll buy and then I'll just never get any use out of, so I'm gonna pass on that. But these are the Juvia's Place blush palettes I was talking about on my eyes if I have to. They're so gorgeous. Other than that, there's not really anything else I wanted to talk about, so I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. If you guys have anything that you want me to feature on the Will I Buy It videos, definitely go ahead and tag me on Instagram, Karen Harris Makeup. Just tag me, then I can, you know, screenshot that and remember to let you guys know if I will or will not be buying it in these videos. So anyway, thanks so much for your time, guys. I hope this video wasn't too long, and don't forget to subscribe down below. Have a great day. Bye.